Welcome back. With us now live over the phone is Dr. Mohammed Salim, member of board of directors of the Arab Council for Sustainable Energy. Good morning, Dr. Salim.
Good morning. How are you? Thank you.
Fine, sir. It's a real pleasure to have you with us in the breakfast show. And of course, this project is the largest green project taken at the Suez Canal Economic Zone by the Saudi company Aqua project. What is the economic significance of this project? How powerful, how helpful could it be to empower the environment inside or boost green economy inside the Suez Canal Economic Zone?
Okay, good morning. Really, it's my pleasure to be with you today to delve into key aspects of the signature ceremony for the Green Hydrogen Framework Agreement between the Egyptian government and Aqua Power, the Saudi company. Really, this is a historical point of developing such mega projects with the witness of Mr. Prime Minister. This is also aligned with the transformation or transformative era in Egypt's energy landscape. With the significant importance and strategic geographical position of Egypt, Egypt can play a leadership role in sustainable energy. This is evidenced by a series of groundbreaking mega projects focused on clean energy, notably the green hydrogen strategy. Egypt has also established the National Council for Green Hydrogen to boost green investment at last August 2023. This initiative serves as a clear manifestation of our commitment to a greener and more sustainable future, aligning with the National Renewable Energy Strategy goal of achieving 42% by 2023. According to the signed agreement, this project represents the initial phase of the Green Hydrogen Initiative, boasting a production capacity of up to 600,000 tons per year of green ammonia and a total investment of about $4 billion. Notably, there are plans for expansion also, as Ministry of Electricity and Renewable Energy mentioned, that there is a forward-looking vision targeting a production scale of 2 million tons per year in subsequent phases. Let us think about or focus about the economic significance of such projects in economy of Egypt. I'd like to address one important point regarding to the green hydrogen. Green hydrogen serves as a valuable form of energy storage rather than being a primary energy source. In this context, surplus electricity generated from renewable sources like wind or solar, and in our case here there is a wind, about 1.1 giga wind energy will sourced to this project, can be utilized for the production of hydrogen via electrolyzers. The stored hydrogen acts as an energy reservoir and can be converted back into electricity by fuel cells, or can be also formed in different carriers like green ammonia or green methanol, which are important for fueling ships and transportation facilities. All these issues support the economy of Egypt. One more point regarding to the job creation. Such projects needs a high caliber and potential workforce for construction, operation, and maintenance. Then the area will be civilized and will be a dynamic and full of employment opportunities and improving the local communities. One more point regarding to the technology transfer. Such projects makes needs technology transfer for renewable energy and also for the technology of production of hydrogen. All these issues improve the economy of Egypt. The final point in this question, I'd like to say that infrastructure development to establish a green hydrogen project requires the development of infrastructure, including renewable energy facilities, storage system, transmission lines, substations, and all these infrastructure development can have a positive cascading effect on the overall economic development of Egypt. Yes.
Right. The Egyptian market is considered one of the most important open markets receiving renewable energy investment within the Egyptian, of course, states planning to empower and boost that type of market. So what is the importance of investing in renewable energy? We all know that the language of the coming future is the renewable energy. So how important could be empowering the projects of renewable energy be able to advance with economy, take Egypt to a whole new level, improve investment and all that?
Yes, really Egypt play a crucial role in this aspect. And established a goal, strategic goal, for renewable energy to be 42% by 2035, and to exceed or to improve this strategic goal, then this is 42% will be by 2030. That needs a lot of projects of renewable energy to be established in Egypt. And also there is a lot of contract or MOUs so far, and also the area to assign the in Sohag area, and Aqua Power also takes a large area there to establish around 10 giga of wind energy. Moreover, also diversifying of the energy sources by investing in renewable energy, Egypt takes significant strides in the diversifying its energy sources. This helps reduce dependence on the traditional fossil fuel, as you see also the traditional fossil fuel, natural gas, for example, and mazot. This is now high expensive, and this really needs to be replaced with the renewable energy. Also, the sustainable development goal, to minimize the environmental impact of carbon emissions, aligning with the global efforts to combat the climate change. As we see now, the latest levelized cost of energy generated by renewable energy is increasingly competitive to the fossil fuel. This not only enhances the competitiveness, but also contributes to improved economic of efficiency. The last levelized cost at the previous tenders, it's reached around 2 cents per kilowatt hour for solar, and around 2.6 for wind. So these prices are very competitive, and really can be implemented clearly in our grid.
Right. Of course, the implementation of this project in particular is important to maintain Egypt's lead in implementing green hydrogen projects, like we earlier said. So how important is it for Egypt to exist in that particular field, to prove its existence in that particular field and be a strong competitor amongst power countries? As we all know that most of the countries are competing now to take lead in that particular projects.
Sure, our region has demonstrated a lot of renewable energy projects, and also Egypt one of them, and in the leader position of that. So Egypt to be also in good global reputation and partnership, mentioned that a lot or many or several of partnership of projects of renewable energy, and also attractiveness to international investor, providing an opportunity to export clean energy abroad also. Europe now asks our region to receive to import clean energy, so it is also a good opportunity to work on that. Moreover, reduce carbon emissions. So green hydrogen is sourced by renewable energy, that making it a clean and sustainable energy carrier. Implementing such projects can contribute to the reduction of carbon emissions, aligning with the global efforts to combat climate change. Really, it's a potential attracting environmental conscious investors and more and more. One more point regarding to the technology, I want to tell such a project of green ammonia by producing green hydrogen in Suez Canal zone, and the source of this will be at wind energy or at Jabal Zayt or even at Suhad. So to transmit this huge amount of electricity from the source to the demand at Suez Canal, this also needs to reinforce the transmission lines and substations. So this is also will make improvement and attractive to the investors to make investment in such projects.
Right. How do you weigh the efforts to localize the manufacture of electrolyzer components in the region and make it a standard, or a, I mean, develop with all the old-fashioned standards of manufacture or industry inside the region, according, of course, in accordance with the standards and with accordance with the vision of 2030 and the Sustainable Development Goals?
And now we came to the most important issue regarding to the manufacturing here, the industry. To build, to localize the industry in Egypt, this is really needs a great attention, and also to invest with the partners, international partners, to build such factories here in Egypt. As we know, manufacturing contributes to economic development within the region in advanced manufacturing and technology, and also enhances supply chain resilience. You see, by reducing dependence on international suppliers, the region can mitigate the risks associated with the disruptions in the global supply chain. So to be stable production process. Local manufacturing encourages also technology transfer and innovative by collaboration between local manufacturers and international technology providers can lead to the adaptation and improvement of electrolyzer technologies. We have the human resources, we have the caliber and potential people, workforce, but needs really to make such partnership with international company to make this localization real in our area. And the area of Suez Canal is the best fit for such a project.
Right. To what extent is it important to start replacing the or the old power stations that operate on fuel fossil with disposable ones, with those that depend on renewable energy? And because these particular components, their deficiency have ended and does not cope with the new millennium. So how important is it to replace it with the new ones that adapt with the hydrogen, the framework of the green transition and the hydrogen projects?
Okay, once again, we came to a critical aspect regarding to the fossil fuel power plants. The aging power plants that should be retirement and replacement, the old power station, which has low efficiency. But so far, such projects needs a deep study, because also we cannot depend on the renewable energy 100% at this time, as the time being. But in future, and near future really, once we use the storage systems and make the electricity security and reliable, so we can really retire the aging power plants and replace. Also, we have a project now in Egypt to replace or phase out around 5 gigawatt of old power plants, but still in, I think it is in study now. Really, regarding to this, many countries are committed to reducing their carbon footprint and increasing the share of renewable energy in their energy mix by phasing out fossil fuel-based power plants and replacing them with renewable energy alternatives. This transition also signals a commitment to a low-carbon future and positions the country as a leader in the global effort to combat climate change. It is really needs a great effort, but the decision is not easy, really, because these assets exist and is still in operation. It is in low efficiency, but needs a finance decision in that. Yes.
Right, Dr. Mohammed Salim, member of the board of directors of the Arab Council for Sustainable Energy. Would like to thank you, sir, so much talking to The Breakfast Show, and you have a beautiful day.